Helen's dead and you can't even say sorry.
Because the accident wasn't my fault.
You tried using Dylan to get between Trevor and Grace. It's Dylan's blood on your hands, isn't it?
Why were you calling Trevor in the village earlier? Were you going to tell him?
What's wrong? Are you scared?
Please, Nico, you can't.
Dylan was the only thing that made being stuck in this dump okay.
I know, and I get that. I'm sorry.
Now he's dead because of you. Everyone I love leaves me. First my dad, now Dylan. It isn't fair, it's just not.
Nico, Trevor isn't a nice man. Don't you think Curtis would have had a happier life if it was with me and Esther, his mum? I mean, Trevor didn't do anything for Dylan, did he?
It's all on here. The things you said, pretending to be Dylan's friend.
You cannot tell Trevor.
I am gonna show Trevor everything you wrote. What happens next is up to him.
But before, when I said I had blood on my hands, I was talking about my twin sister, Kath. She had an accident when she was younger, and it was all my fault. Just please, I didn't mean to hurt Dylan. I was just in love with Esther. Just put the phone down.
Like I care about your sister.
Well, is someone going to tell me what's going on?
Give me that phone, please. It's all I have left of him.
Vince, don't you think I'm to blame for Dylan's death?
The crash wasn't Kim's fault, all right? We've been over this. You've got to stop looking for someone to blame, all right?
You're just saying that because you're protecting her.
Vince, if Trevor sees what's on that phone, you're going to be picking out hymns.
Dylan was a good kid, all right? I bet he'd be so proud for you sticking up for him, but you've got to let it go.
Could you if you were me?
I don't know, but it won't bring him back.
Nico, wait. She's right. I am not to blame for Dylan's death. So please, can you not show Trevor what's on that phone? I'm really scared.
Is it really your sister's blood on your hands?
Yeah. Look, she may as well be dead because of me, and I deserve to be punished for that. I don't deserve to be punished for Dylan.
You're not going to say anything about this, right?
We won't say a word if you don't.
Thank you.
Hey, what do you reckon? One day, all this could be yours.
Didn't you get my message?
I'm a bit old for games at the Folly, Nico.
Look, I found out that someone was bullying Dylan before he died.
So?
So we should make them pay.
Go home, Nico. Look, and stop texting me from his phone. Have you any idea what that does to me, seeing his name come up on the screen? No, for a second, I forget that he's gone, and then I remember. And it's like losing him all over again every time.
You would not be doing nothing if you knew what was on here.
I do something stupid. What happens to him?
He ends up in a home. So what, I survived?
Yeah, what a little bundle of joy you turned out to be.
So that's it then? Do nothing?
From now on, my family comes first. I only wish I'd realised that while Dylan was still here. So the only thing I can do is make sure he gets the send-off he deserves. So that's what I'm going to do.
Ashley Davidson gave Carly loads of gifts. You know, maybe there's something in here, some evidence that could implicate her.
Frank, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Nico, don't touch that.
No, she's okay.
Bought her a new charm every birthday, right?
Yeah.
Ben, I hate seeing you like this.
Do you know how hard it was having to see Ashley Davidson just drive away?
No, of course I don't. But I do know how it feels to pretend to the world that you're okay when you're screaming inside. So, you don't need to pretend to me.
Today's Carly's birthday. She'd have been 25. I'd have made her a chocolate and hazelnut cake. It's her favourite. Oh, I'd have bought her a chocolate hazelnut cake. And a charm for a bracelet.
Ben, you are no use to anyone in the state. Why don't we book a few days off? Find somewhere to go away, make some new memories, just you and me.
I'd love that, really. But I can't. Not until I do what's right for Carly.
I don't know why you wanted to help me with these. Thought you could stand me.
School's out. Got nothing better to do.
Except getting a rook, looks like.
You should see the other girl. Where's Curtis?
Leela's looking after him for a few days. I didn't want him to be around. Around this.
I'm sorry about what I said. I know you care about Dylan.
Yeah, but we all say stupid things when we're grieving. There's one way you can make it up to me. Get your mum's copper boyfriend to back off.
Believe me, I wish she'd forget all about it. See you tomorrow.
Police warrant. Anonymous tip-off.
I'm the evening for my son's funeral. You're all right, you are.
Listen, you come to Holly again, I'll kill you.
Hey, don't you dare!
So when were you going to tell me about your little old pup?
What are you talking about?
I know the real reason you let Robbie go, so stop playing dumb.
There's nothing here.
Don't you ever talk to a superior officer like that again. I'll do whatever I have to do to put pawn life like that away. It's not your place to question it.
Your grass has got it all wrong, right? There's nothing here.
This is Carly's. It's from her bracelet. Fell off in a struggle, did it? Arrest him.
I've never seen that thing before in my life.
Arresting you in the connection.
You can't do this!
Carly Bradley, you do not have to say anything, but it may harm your defence if you do not mention when questioned something which you later rely on in court.
Don't, I've been set up. You're not stupid, so you know I'm not stupid. Someone planted that charm.
Lock him up. Right now, Trevor's in a cell. Thanks to the evidence your daughter planted.
Good.
Nico, how could you?
Ben, I just wanted to help both of us. Dylan's dead because of Trevor. And he killed Carly. I knew this would solve everything.
Do you know how serious planting evidence is?
Please. I couldn't handle prison. You can't tell anyone.
Yeah, well, I won't have to. There's not enough for the CPS to prosecute. And we can't keep Trevor more than 24 hours. But your help stops now, do you hear me? Carly's murder has nothing to do with you.
So what time are you going to Blackpool?
Oh, some of that mine.
Where did you pop up from?
There's no hot water at ours, so Diane let me use the shower.
That reminds me, I need to go and check on her before I feed Hannah. But you look after this, and no, these are all spoken for.
Well, don't forget your camera.
Hey, is everything all right with you two?
Go and get dressed, will you?
Hey, have you got any spare undies? I left my fresh pair at home. Right, well, looks like I'm going to have to go commando then.
Never going to work.
Well, don't tell me you got a caught in the fly's horror story.
I'm not talking about going commando. I'm talking about your pathetic little attempts to get with me. Never going to work.
Time!
10:25.
Look, my son's funeral's at 1.
And I don't have to release you until 4.
Oh, it's probably for the best. Missed all the other milestones in Dylan's life. First word, first day in school, first line in the nativity play. Shepherd number 3, apparently. Thought he probably wanted to play Mary.
Don't let the door hit you on the way out.
No solicitor, no tape.
Just me, you, and the truth. Who killed Carly?
You are out of control.
No,
I'm taking control. Someone has to.
Ben will be interviewing Trevor right now. Maybe he'll even believe him. Find out the car wasn't actually outside the house.
Why do you think I planted the charm? It was him or me.
Yeah, and you have just made that far too obvious. Look, this has to stop now. No more faking, no more scheming.
Says the world champion.
Nico Blake, you will do as I tell you.
Or what? You'll hand me in? Tempted, aren't you? Blame everything on me. Pray Ben will forgive you. No more stress, no more secrets. But you can't do that to me.
Why? Because you'll tell Ben that I hit you?
No, because I'm your daughter.
Where are you going?
To bury my boyfriend!
Dylan bought me one a few months back. A scissor-tail sergeant.
I asked you about my daughter. And all you keep talking to me about is fish.
They're hardcore scissor-tails. You heard of filial cannibalism?
Gee, I haven't got time for this.
Scissor-tail sergeants kill their own kids. So did you. You killed Carly. Like I killed Dylan.
What?
All right. We never struck the blow. But we might as well have. I was Dylan's dad. I let him down. I deserve everything I get.
What about Ashley Davison? What does she deserve?
Don't talk to me about that mad cow. You think I want to be part of her world? It's done me in.
Did you and Ashley Davison kill my little girl?
No. I never touched her, and neither did Ashley. The only thing that matters is that Carly's gone. Like Dylan's gone. We're never gonna get him back.
Hey, lunchtime already? Well, come and try your old man's new twist on a virgin pina colada.
Yeah, I really like it.
Yeah, Steve, try this, something new.
No, thanks. I'm happy with what I've got.
Oh, well, suit yourself. Hey, I've seen that look before. You still a mess with you and Cleo.
Yeah. Yeah, you know, we'd be so good together if I could just say how I felt. And whenever I try, it just goes pear-shaped, so whatever.
Well, don't say it then. Write it. I can always dig out a few of the old love poems from back in the day.
No, thanks.
Hey, wrote your mum this lovely one once. Two fresh melons. Yeah. It's a clever double meaning. On the surface, it's about how sweet these melons actually are. And on a deeper level, it was about how sweet it was when me and your mum...
That, like I said, no thanks.
Suit yourself, but trust me, the written word will get you heard. Hey, you hear that? It's like poetry's gushing out of me, like...
Like juice out of a fresh melon?
Yeah, see? You've inherited the Hutchinson talent. So use it to get what you want.
You and Dylan, you were close, weren't you?
Grow up in care and you never let yourself get too close to anyone. You never know when they might be moving on.
You don't have to bottle things up, love.
Yeah, I do. I wish everyone else would too. People spill way too many secrets in this place.
When you get a little bit older, like me, you'll realise that talking is better than silence. Because you don't always have long left.
Dress.
Dylan liked it. He looked really good in it too.
Let him go?
Yeah. Well, couldn't keep a man from his son's funeral, could I? You okay? You look an age.
Ben, come to the funeral with me. Please.
Sure.
Nico! You should ride up front.
Look, I know it's not the best time, but we need to talk about Nico.
Hi.
are you gone? I'm all alone. No one else is a freak like me. Like we were together. So I've written this for you. My life without you. It bleeds, Dylan. The wound scabs. Red. Raw. Scar tissue grows from grief. But this blood won't clot. It flows. Forever. Until we all die. Alone. In barren fear.
Great. Dylan would have loved it.
Dylan was a better man than me. He was braver too. Because he was who he was. Not what the world wanted him to be. And now, without him... People say you've got to have hope. But how do you have hope when you lose your child? Because there's some things you can mend and put back together, but not this. You're never going to see that big grin. That glint in his eye. That bad haircut ever again. You know I was proud of you, right?
Messing up when I talk to you. So someone said I should write instead. And it's not just because you're fit, though you totally are. It's because with you, I'll feel alive. With you, I'll be the man I want to be. And yeah, it's complicated with your relationship and your baby. And it would be crazy difficult with my dad, but it'd be so worth it.
Wherever
Ben, it's Nico. Yeah, she said she wants to be with Dylan.
You don't think she's gonna do something stupid, do you?
We've got to find her.
So what's this big emergency? Right, don't tell me, is that meat supplier giving you hassle again?
He is, but I'll sort that. Well, that's not why I ask you here. I've designed a new menu for tomorrow and I wanted you to check out the font and typeface.
Oh, do I look like the type of bloke who cares about typefaces?
It's on here somewhere. Oh no.
Has there been some sort of font disaster?
I don't know. We'll download it to your laptop. Come on, let's go.
Sweetheart! Oh, thank goodness. Sweetheart, I'm so sorry I didn't stay with you. Just Ben was so torn up.
No harm done, yeah? She just needed to spend some time with Dylan, right? And I'm fine. No, just being here, seeing Trevor. All I could think about was Carly.
You have got to let this vendetta go or it will kill you.
Vendetta? What? You want me to forget about my daughter being murdered?
No, of course not, but look what it's doing to us all.
I have to do what's right.
I know, but she has already lost Mark and Dylan and her grandfather's dying and I'm just trying to protect her, Ben, and I don't know how. Yeah, I feel like the worst mother in the whole world.
Let's just go home.
No, we need to sort this.
It will be sorted. It's just going to take time.
It's going to take the truth.
The truth?
That's what it will take.
Ben, I need to be alone with my mum, please.
I'll wait by the gates.
So you're just going to tell Ben the truth? You're going to choose him over your own daughter? They'll send me away. My life will be over.
I don't know what else to do, Nico. Hey, this is the only way we're ever going to get past what happened. Please, don't you see that?
Pull yourself together, Mummy dearest.
Because if you breathe a word to Ben, he'll put you in a grave. For good.